I have always enjoyed playing with RC toy cars, and now that I know a bit of electronics, I intend to make one. In that case, I will definitely need a wireless interface. In this video, let's create one such wireless interface using nRF24L01 along with Arduino to transmit potentiometer reading from one end to another. Let's get started. For this mini project, I bought bunch of nRF24L01 and two 3.3V Arduino Pro Mini, as nRF24L01 is 3.3V compatible device. I also bought FT232RL FTDI USB to UART converter, as it has DTR pin which is needed while programming Arduino Pro Mini. Mini talk number 3 covers this topic in detail, don't forget to check it out. nRF24L01 is single chip transceiver operating in 2.4 GHz ISM band. Its supply voltage range from 1.9 to 3.6 volt. It consumes 11.3 mA at 0 dB transmission power and 13.5 mA at 2 Mbps air data rate. It also provides 4 transmitter power settings and 3 different data rate settings. It uses SPI as interface to microcontrollers. Breakout board of nRF24L01 available in market contains 8 pins, which aggregates to 2 supply pins, 4 SPI pins, 1 chip enable and 1 interrupt pin. I connected nRF24L01 module to Arduino Pro Mini as shown in this schematic. Connections of transmitter and receiver sides are identical, except transmitter contains potentiometer whose value will be received by receiver. I used female jumper wires to put together receiver circuitry and used breadboard along with some jumper wires to put together transmitter circuitry. Once that was done, I moved to coding part. First, we need to install required dependency. That is a library called RF24. Go to Sketch, Include Libraries, Manage Libraries. Search for RF24 and install it. Now let's write code for transmitter side. Include SPI and RF24 libraries. Create variable for potentiometer and a variable of RF24 class with chip enable and chip select pins. Also create a variable defining address of pipe used by transmitter to send data. In setup, declare potentiometer pin as input. Radio.begin will initialize operation of NRF chip. Each chip connected will verify if NRF is connected to SPI pins. Do not proceed until it returns 1. Now, open writing pipe, set power amplifier level and call stop listening function. This will put NRF in transmitter mode. In loop part, read analog pin value and transmit it using write function. That's it for transmitter side. In receiver code, again include SPI and RF24 libraries. Create variable of RF24 class and create address variable with same value as transmitter. In setup, initialize serial interface and check for SPI connectivity. Open reading pipe, set power amplifier level and start listening. In loop, wait for data availability and if available, read it and display on serial monitor. I uploaded code to respective boards and I was able to move potentiometer at one end and receive its value at another. So guys, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed and learned something from it. Please subscribe to this channel for more videos and thanks for watching.